One man says just a routine trip to a city dump changed the course of his life. 4 years later, injuries caused by an accident there have only gotten worse. Four investigator Brittany Costello breaks down the search for answers and concerns safety at that facility is still lacking.
Quality time looks a little different these days for Lawrence Gonzalez and his son Eugene.
Like he told me, you don't feel it now, but you're gonna start feeling aches and pains.
A master landscaper, he's doing way more sitting and sifting through piles of medical documents.
This is later in June, right? Your x-ray follow-ups?
Yeah.
June of 2019 is when everything changed. A trip to the Eagle Rock Convenience Center was common for Gonzalez, who has worked manual labor his whole life.
Yeah, his whole background is just work, landscaping, manual labor.
No surprise, he was unloading branches and bush trimmings in 2019. That's him in the black shirt.
When he had told me about everything that was going on, it was just like, it wasn't as intense as it was when I saw the video.
When a loader drives by, it grabs his trimmings and pulls him into the waste pit.
He was pretty pale. He looked really bad. He was crying in pain.
Another camera angle shows his head landing dangerously close to a wheel. Initially, Gonzalez and his family thought the injuries were minor until the pain got worse.
I've never seen my dad that bad, that much in pain or, you know, anything like the swelling and just how banged up he was.
And then everything else started to unravel. Gonzalez was fired from his job since he couldn't perform the same tasks. He lost his living space on the property of the business he worked for. Depression and more health issues followed.
It's tough. Like it bugs me a lot, like emotionally.
The Gonzalez family hired an attorney to sue the city and employees, saying they both failed in their responsibility to keep people safe.
Around the same time, another lawsuit was filed against the same city employee who drove the loader that hit Gonzalez. A second incident at the same facility injured another man just 3 months before Gonzalez's accident. The city didn't have video, and photos don't show what was described in court documents. According to the lawsuit, the city employee driving the same loader backed out of the garage and hit another customer. That case is still unresolved.
We requested documents from the city about that driver working that day. Were there other incidents or just these two? And what happened as a result of them? The city says it's working to gather that information. We're going on 2 months.
But it's not just customers who've sued over this. The loader driver filed his own lawsuit, claiming he alerted the city to serious safety concerns at that facility, but he was ignored. The employee recalls specifically telling the city it needed to install safety barriers. Something that still hasn't happened 4 years later. The city refused to talk about safety upgrades since then. But we did notice some warning honks when the loader passed by those bays, and additional signage that seemed to show exactly what happened to Gonzalez.
Waiting and waiting is just, it's too much. Like 4 years is way too long.
Their case hasn't gone anywhere.
Oh, it's stressful. It's like stresses me out like crazy.
While they wait, those daily tasks get harder and harder.
Was your dad having any issues working or getting work done prior to this accident?
No.
Slowly losing any hope they once had of getting help they believe they deserve. Brittany Costello, 4 Investigates.
Albuquerque city officials say they cannot comment on pending litigation, but they do say the Solid Waste Management Department is continually working to ensure the safety of its employees and customers. We are told the employee in question here, who was driving the loader, is no longer with the city.